At his town hall, Joe Biden talked about the filibuster, which is currently stopping pretty much everything from happening. Most recently, the compromise of a compromise voting bill that the Republicans successfully blocked with a filibuster this week. Here's what Joe Biden had to say about that.
But I also think we're going to have to move to the point where we fundamentally alter the filibuster. The idea that, for example, my Republican friends say that we're going to default on the national debt because they're going to filibuster that and we need 10 Republicans to support us is the most bizarre thing ever heard. I think you're going to see, if they gets pulled again, I think you're going to see an awful lot of Democrats being ready to say, not me, I'm not doing that again. We're going to end the filibuster. But it still is difficult to end the filibuster beyond that. That's another issue.
But are you saying once you get this current agenda passed on spending and social programs that you would be open to fundamentally altering the filibuster
or doing away with
it, or doing away with it?
Well, that remains to be seen.
But when it comes to voting rights,
is equally as consequential.
When it comes to voting rights, just so I'm clear, though, you would entertain the notion of doing away with the filibuster on that one issue. Is that correct?
And maybe more.
And maybe other issues.
Okay, so right there, you hear him say he would be willing to do it for that and many more. And he said that you might have at some point, I don't know why we would still need things to prod the Democrats into supporting this. What have they not seen that they yet need to see? But the issue is that you can get as many as you want as long as you do not get all 50. And you don't have all 50, they're not going to reform it. Manchin and Sinema, and like Nina Turner was saying earlier, probably 2 to 6 more are not going to do it, even for carve outs for things like voting rights. Meanwhile, our voting rights are getting shredded, which is not only objectively wrong in a democracy, but will also make it substantially harder for the Democrats to win the elections necessary to get into the Senate to eventually reform the filibuster. It's an amazing self-fulfilling prophecy in that way. So he seems okay with the idea, but we're no closer to actually getting it done. Not based on anything that I've seen, but feel free to let me know if you disagree.
No, and there it is. I mean, you just laid it out, John, it makes no sense. All roads lead back to voting. So in order to vote, to elect people who hopefully might do something on behalf of the people, we gotta make sure that voting is expanded and protected. We know throughout the states in this country that Republicans are absolutely having a field day with it. We also know historically the filibuster has been used for very racist means. I mean, most often used to stop civil rights legislation, just period. So they should have been taking care of this. Now, the point that he's making about getting the infrastructure passed and both the hard and social infrastructure passed. Okay, I'm gonna give the president that. But at the same time, making it very clear that we cannot continue on this course. It is very disruptive to the whole of democracy. And the fact that for the People Act is going nowhere, the John Lewis Voting Rights Act might go somewhere. They allow Manchin to introduce a watered down version of For the People Act that does nothing with dark money. Ask the brother to bring 10 Republicans. He had one job to try to bring 10 Republicans across the line to pass his version of the legislation. Why they would give this man this kind of deference just absolutely boggles my mind, especially since it has been revealed that he thinking about going independent any daggone way. Why are they letting this man be the shadow president? He out of the shadows. He just flat out acting as if he's the president. But let me just give one more thing. Back to President Johnson, what he said about voting. A man without a vote is a man without protection. Let me throw people in there. But people without a vote are people without protection. That is it. All roads lead to two things. We need campaign finance reform, and we need to make sure that we are expanding and protecting the ballot box. They go hand in hand. And the fact that these people don't get that and understand that enough, and the African American community in particular, not the only issues that we care about, but historically voting and the way we got the ability to be able to vote in this country is so deep seated in our liberation in this country. And overwhelmingly, we support the Democratic Party disproportionately. Other people will dance and date other folks. We got a wide coalition, don't get me wrong, but African Americans are the loyalist base of the Democratic Party. The fact that they are not putting a higher premium on ensuring that voting is secure and expanded and getting away and getting rid of the filibuster boggles my mind.
Yes, especially when they consistently rely on the African American vote time and time again and propping up people like Kyrsten Sinema and Joe Manchin to come through, please make the calls, please do all this. You know, we're gonna get the majority. And look, you know, what happened in North Carolina or in Georgia, excuse me, what happened in Georgia and Raphael Warnock and John Ossoff, yeah. You know, and the amount of effort that took and the grassroots organizations, you know, from black organizations to Asian American organizations to Latino voters, just everyone, it was such a group effort, and they're squandering it, right? And just again, his stance in that town hall, I mean, I don't know, they need to do these in the morning or something or whenever he's at the peak, because he's just so defeated. Yeah, maybe more, I don't know, doopy doo. Like, it's so, I'm so unconvinced. And I know a lot of media outlets are like, hey, maybe this will really do something, and they're very excited about it. I don't see a man who is convinced. I don't see a person, a politician, who is going to lead this charge. I see someone who feels already defeated around the things that he's trying to get done. Yeah. And he's allowing others to stymie him. And I just want to say, like, all of this makes me realize, you know, we talk about the inside political strategy. A lot of this gets very wonky. Who's meeting with whom? Who's moving on this and that? And we have to remember that the outside political strategy of mass movements and pressure and grassroots organizing is so important and valuable, especially when, again, we are being utterly lied to about the good faithness of any of these senators, yeah. About the Democratic, the fact that the Senate is undemocratic in and of itself. Speaking about legacies of racism and slavery in this country, the Senate was enshrined to protect minority rule, and that's what it does. Why do you have 50 Republicans who represent millions fewer than the 50 or 49 other Democratic senators, right? Like, we understand that. And so we're at the end of our rope. And back in, you know, 30 years ago, maybe, you know, I was like a young, like, lefty coming up, like, you know, protesting the war in Iraq. And I was like, electoral politics, F it all, you know? Yeah. And I feel that way. But it's like the people in charge are going to sink us all, bringing us all down together, and they're gonna float up on their little, you know, buoys of cash.
Yeah.
So like, we can't afford to not care about this, but we still need to maintain, I wouldn't even say like a certain amount of militancy when it comes to mass pressure.
100%, yeah. Yeah, and I understand the system is obviously absolutely disgusting, but I also know that if Republicans could push a button and have every single person like you were then give up on electoral politics for the rest of your life, they would jam it until it broke.
Yes.
Both of you have talked about history, about how the filibuster has been used. I think historically, more than 50% of the filibusters for several decades were specifically stopping any sort of civil rights reforms. And you know, you were, Francesca, you were just talking about how messed up and unrepresentative the Senate is. And there are things that have changed in the past 50, 60 years, but there are some things that haven't nearly as much. And so I want to demonstrate that, playing a video that we've played before on the show. And it has to do with a bunch of racists and some moderates using the filibuster to protect the voting suppression that's going on. This is a video of Martin Luther King Jr. And other than that, it could be played today and be just as accurate about what's going on. Take a look at this.
Well, I think the tragedy is that we have a Congress with a Senate that has a minority of misguided senators who will use the filibuster to keep the majority of people from even voting. They won't let the majority senators vote. And certainly they wouldn't want the majority of people to vote, because they know they do not represent the majority of the American people. In fact, they represent in their own states a very small minority.
It's 100% true. Everything that the Republicans are doing in the Senate, in state legislatures, demonstrates that they do not have 1 ounce of faith that they will ever get a majority of the country to support them or their agenda. Assuming that someday they ever have an agenda again, other than tax cuts, voter suppression, and occasionally demonizing transgender athletes. Other than that, they have nothing. They don't feel the need to get anything because they are every day building on the multi-layered, unrepresentative, biased system that we have. And it comes in a lot of different forms, the Electoral College, the fact that you can gerrymander, the inherent system of representation in the Senate, all of this. And they've been adding layers of voter suppression to it for decades and decades and decades. It was bad in 1963 when that video was recorded, and it's gotten worse basically every year since then, especially since the Supreme Court decided that I guess states aren't racist anymore and you don't need the Voting Rights Act. And the last couple of years might be the worst of all. And the Democratic Party has an obligation, a duty to be the one, the only party to stand up for democracy. If you're not gonna have two, you should at least have one, and they're not doing it. Kyrsten Sinema and Joe Manchin and a few others would prefer to have the filibuster as a shield, not a shield that protects democracy, but a shield that protects them from ever having to do anything in the Senate. And if the cost of that is that the voters of Georgia, who've done unimaginable work to finally elect two senators, if that gets taken away in the next cycles because of the new voter suppression, then he's fine with that. If Texas, which has been trending blue, if they halt that in its tracks, then that's fine. If they can flip Arizona and some other states by making it so difficult for Democrats to vote, Joe Manchin and Kyrsten Sinema aren't gonna lose any sleep over that. And that could not be any more clear. But as Francesca said, Joe Biden, if he understands these stakes, he's sure not acting like it.
These things are not separate. They're very much a part of the whole. They really do go together. And that is what we need the Democrats to understand. I believe that the Democrats are going to get handed next year in 2022. Because another point that Francesca made, that even if we get the crumbs, how they put it out there, when do the everyday people feel the impact of the crumbs remains to be seen. And will it be in enough time to actually sway the voters that their material conditions have changed or will be changing soon? That is going to impact 2022. Yeah. Democrats need to wield power. It's finite. You don't have it all the time. And really the difference between the Democrats and the Republicans wouldn't give a care. They're gonna wield that power. I mean, Senator McConnell is wielding that power. He got an ironclad lock on his caucus. They don't give it. And I wish the American people, although I'm a Democrat, had more of a choice. But they really, because the Republicans have lost their ever loving minds. And the Democrats ain't far from it because they're not wielding that power that was given to them. And yeah, Georgia brought it on home, but I think it's going to be squandered. And Democrats are going to have a serious awakening that is beyond politics because it has consequences to the people who depend on the government to stand up for them and do their bidding. They're going to get handed in 2022.
Super fast, we're at a breaking point for sure. And this pandemic proved that we don't have a country anymore. And I'm reminded of the quote, it's either socialism or barbarism. It's either democratic socialism, it's actual social programs for the people, or it's barbarism. And it's all the kind of warfare that the crazy Republicans, as Nina Turner said, who've lost their damn minds, what they're pushing us to. So make a choice.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.